Hey, what's going on, everybody? Red Rhino Music here, bringing you another video. Today we're back on NASCAR Heat 5 to do this Michigan race. Typically, I do these sorts of races on a Friday, but I had no power all last week up until Sunday night at like 7 p.m. That storm on the East Coast ended up knocking out my power since Tuesday at like 3. So here I am. We're a little late, but at least we're here. Unfortunately, I missed the race. I missed both races, the Saturday one and the Sunday one. And I had a feeling because I was going to probably miss those, I knew Kevin Harvick was going to get that double up, or at least somebody was going to get that double up. I felt it. And that ended up happening, and of course I missed it. Hopefully I could catch those if they put them online or something. But yeah, I had no internet, no power, no nothing. Anyways, with that all out of the way, we went ahead and qualified already. We're going to be starting in 18th. I have a pretty decent setup. I spent a little extra time working on it just to get a feel for the game again. I haven't played in a couple days, so kind of had to get used to it. The only driving I've been doing is actual driving, and that doesn't translate the same way. We have a pretty good tune, though. Car's pretty stable. I don't know where we're going to end up running. I can run up higher, but I think the bottom end's just going to be better to make passes. But we'll have to see what the AI do. Let's get into it. All right, here we go. Some reason this track looks really good. I forget what the other track is in this game, but I always say it looks pretty good. But this one looks really nice right here. The lighting's just good. I don't know. Their gearing's a little different. I think they already dropped it down into fourth. We still got a little bit of third to go. A little loose in the draft. We are running pretty high tape, so I'm sure that's got something to do with it. Just got to get the car worn in a little bit. Now, the tires, I took a little extra time just to try to get them to be nice temperatures for a bit of a longer run. And the only problem I have is the right rear. Obviously, that's going to be the one that's easiest to cook. But it's really easy to cook on this track for some reason. Car feels good though. I could put it pretty much anywhere.
Careful, still there.
Found out that front roll bar or whatever the setting is. It's up in the right side menu. Maybe it's the strut thing. I don't know. Pretty sure it's the bar that goes across the inside of the hood. It's like a strut tower brace or something like that, or anti-roll bar. I have no idea. I'm not a mechanic. Whatever that thing is, that actually plays like a pretty big role in this game as far as your setup. So lowering it a lot will make your car kind of turn in on its own. Raising it a bit makes it a little stable, but it's going to make you do this and drive somebody up the track. If you don't get out of the throttle a little bit. I feel like I just tripped up Blaney. He went to go for the push on us and I just dove up the track. He got confused. I don't know why he didn't just go for the pass at that point. Car still feels a little loose. It's definitely that right rear tire just being that hot. I feel like you want them at like 200 max. Anything above 200, you're going to really start to feel it. But it's nothing I can't drive.
All right, you're clear.
I was worried I was going to have no power for like this week too, though. Because the estimate... Well, first of all, I should say the power company in my state's pretty not good. They like raised the... Okay, Blaney. Okay, bro. Okay, what are you trying to do? Kill me or push me? I don't understand. Alright, now I'm distracted. Anyways, the power company's kind of a mess here. The whole government's mad at them. They tried to raise the rates during like the whole pandemic thing where everybody's working from home. They tried to bump up the rates 1,500%. And then, obviously, we've had storms like this that knock out the power for like a week. And every time it happens, they're like, yeah, we're taking precautions. We're going to start putting money towards things to make it more, like, reliable. And then, obviously, it wasn't. So, everybody's kind of pissed. Nobody's really pissed at the workers. Like, that's not their fault. But apparently, all the workers are saying that, like, the main company isn't giving them any, like, orders on what to do once they get to the site. Plus, they have to do COVID testing, so it's like probably a couple days after the guys show up, because they're coming out of state, too. We have guys from Canada over here doing this. So they probably have to wait a couple days before they can even work. It's an easy stage one.
Top 10.
Car feels good. It's that right tire I just got to worry about, and apparently Blaney, who's out to get us. Don't know what that's all about. All right. Probably take a squeeze of fuel if we can. And I don't know. Maybe these guys are taking right sides. I don't see them taking four. I don't think they would take four with them at 80%. Yeah, let's go with this. Okay, they took four. Whatever. We're in first now. Let's see how we do. I don't feel like the car's loose. I mean, obviously it's loose when Blaney's out to get us, and the right rear is a little bit loose, but that's because it's getting hot. As long as we keep that safe, everything's pretty good.
All clear.
But yeah, the power company was saying we weren't going to have power until like Wednesday night at midnight, originally, like this upcoming Wednesday. And I was like, oh no.
Car outside.
At least we got it back on Sunday so I could do this video. It's just going to be a little staggered. Rather than the career mode, we can make this up. I don't know what I'm going to do for Friday because it's, I believe it's the road course race at Daytona. And that track doesn't exist in this game, so I don't know what to do.
Outside.
Perhaps we'll just do a second career thing.
Still there.
So I want to do a career mode thing for Wednesday. Maybe we'll do a second one. Yeah, those four tires are coming through for them. Eventually we should even up though. That whole rear bumper thing is messed up from Blaney. I didn't realize we had that much damage. They only said it was, I think it said 0 seconds, but it's pretty bad. It's like a dark yellow. Alright, we just have to wait a little bit. Their tires are going to come back to be pretty even with ours. Maybe I could run the higher line, or at least take it easy on the bottom line. And maybe preserve our tires a little more.
Looking inside now.
These guys really drive it into you, and they're doing these bumps.
All clear.
Yeah, I really didn't expect them to take the four tires. Usually these guys are pretty stingy with the tires. Okay, here we go again. Why are they bumping me sideways? Yeah, look how hot that right rear is getting. That's not good. I wonder if that's because our bumper's bent in, or if that's, yeah, that's bad. That's almost, it's 50 degrees over where I like. I don't know if this is because I'm running aggressive, if the bumper's pressed in or something, maybe it affects it. I have no idea. Because it wasn't getting that hot.
Still there.
But I guess the thing with the hot tires, it makes you lose grip. Okay, that just ended on like lap four. Whatever, we lost a spot. We'll get it back. So our right sides are with them. Our left sides, they're probably at the 88 we were at. Right. I've got the faith. Let's advance.
right, you're coming to the green. Be ready. Bottom's looking good.
Got a little into whoever was on our outside there. I was trying to read our tire pressures and all that. Or, I guess, temperatures. Some reason during caution and stuff, that tire stays hot. I don't know if it's really that hot that it stays that hot. Because usually they'll cool down a little bit.
Inside.
But it's really staying up there.
Hold your line. All right, you're clear.
Alright, I just gotta get back in a groove.
Still there. Alright, clear low. Inside.
Car's not really sticking for me on the entrance of the high side anymore.
All clear. Low's clear.
Definitely get to the bottom, though. I'm wondering if, like, the track bar or something like that affects that rear temp. So I was trying everything I could to get that right rear to stay cool. And it's just so hard to do it. I don't know, maybe if you lift the rear end. So I'm running it flat out, like, all the way low as it gets. Maybe if you lift that rear end, it stays a little cooler, it gets more air or something. Who knows? Wonder if there's something you could do, because if I could control that, then we're all set. So right now, it's just the main factor in our grip. The left side doesn't really matter. It matters just a little bit on, like, drive in and drive off, but it's, like, not even, it's not really affecting our times.
Still there. Clear high, clear high.
Good turn right there. That was almost perfect.
Careful, still there. Careful, still there.
Let's see if we can slide all the way down to the bottom.
Careful, still there. You're all clear up top.
I have that app on my phone. It's called, like, the Score or whatever. It's like a sports app. Gives you, like, news on a game or, like, a play-by-play thing of a game.
High lane's clear.
Or NASCAR. And I was seeing... at one point, I was just getting back-to-back notifications. Harvick takes the lead. Almirola takes the lead. Brad and Blaney took each other out. Harvick takes the lead. Almirola takes the lead. Kyle Busch takes the lead. Almirola takes the lead. Harvick takes the lead. And I was like, Jesus, what's going on? And then obviously they gave me the thing saying Harvick won. And I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. So I know Cindric did that double up a week or two ago, whatever that was. But that's obviously Xfinity. That's not Cup. What the hell just happened here?
Stay low. Still there.
I don't know why I was driving with that info screen open. I was doing some practice earlier when I was tuning the car. I was driving in the cockpit camera. I was actually doing alright with it, but I don't know. It just doesn't give me the information I need. There's just like a disconnect. Same as like the third person stuff. It's like this, I can see where I'm going, I can see where I am, I can put the car wherever I want. If I go into one of those cameras, it's more the car goes where it wants to go. And then it's me reacting to where it is. It's like, obviously I can see this, but like the car is starting to go on a little left for whatever reason. Even though I don't feel like I'm turning to the left. Now I'm like steering, but then I see I'm not steering enough. It's just weird. Four to go, four positions to get. Let's try to drive this thing hard. We could at least get some draft off the corner, we'll be set. Obviously, screw the high line, we're going for gold here. Are these all three of the Toyotas right here? Is this Truex, Busch, and Hamlin, it looks like? I think it is. Can't have that. Three to go.
Careful, still there. All right, clear outside.
A little loose coming out of here, but it's all right.
Careful, still there.
All right, Hamlin, we're going.
You're all clear on the bottom.
Sorry. You're not coming with us, though.
All clear.
Just like that. That's how you do it. All right with us, though. If they do some sort of drafting business or something, they could always catch up.
Left, stay calm.
Did he just say last lap? It's not the last lap. Yeah, we're leaving these guys.
White flag, next time by.
Now it's the last lap. Maybe he said fast lap. I don't know. It sounded like he said last lap, and it confused me. Yep, we're leaving them. I don't know why they're going so slow. I guess it's the tire fall off or something. But they can't be much worse than we are. I mean, they can't be worse than we are. We've been out the longest on these tires. I'm telling you, the left sides and the front, right front are fine. It's just that right rear you gotta handle. There we go. Another win for the books. Do a little burnout for him, why not? Alright. It's enough of a burnout. So yeah, guys, it's another win for the books. It's good stuff. I'm glad I have my power back. I'm glad I didn't miss too many episodes. I was worried if I was gonna miss like a Monday one, and according to the power company, the next Wednesday one. So I was planning on starting to do two career videos a week since we're running Cup and Xfinity in the career now. So I was going to do one Monday, one Wednesday, and then do this sort of thing on the Friday. So that's still the plan. This week's just going to be a little out of order. But next week, everything should be back. For Friday's video, I think we're just going to do that second career race. I don't want to just do like an oval Daytona race because that doesn't really make sense. Plus, I'm pretty sure we're doing that in our career video anyway. So, there's not really a point. Maybe if they add the Daytona Road course, which they said they were, I think. No, they said they're adding Indy Road. I assume they'll do the Daytona one too. If they add that, then we'll go back and do it sometime, but obviously they don't have it now. And that's that as far as NASCAR stuff goes. On the 18th, Flight Simulator comes out, and that's next Tuesday, so I will be playing that sometime next week. So if you're into Flight Simulator, or at least a little interested in it, make sure you stay tuned for that stuff as well. Anyways, guys, that's it for this one. If you like seeing NASCAR Heat on the channel, make sure you hit that like button down below. And if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well so you get notified for when I upload new videos. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See y'all next time. Peace.